everybody. Welcome back to VBS. I hope you guys are ready to hit the job site today. Before we do, let's take a look at the hard work you guys put in yesterday, doing crafts, game, and snacks at home. Take a look. Wow, you guys worked hard yesterday. Maybe some of you are a little tired and stiff from all that hard work. Let's get ready for work today by getting our bodies moving and singing our Concrete and Cranes theme song.
Okay guys, this week our motto here at Concrete and Cranes is Jesus, our strong foundation. Say that with me, Jesus, our strong foundation. Yesterday we learned about the foundation of God's love. Today we're going to keep building that on, that foundation, by learning about God's forgiveness.
Now let's review our VBS memory verse we started yesterday. It's found in Philippians 1:6 and it says, I am sure of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry on to the completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Let's say that together. I am sure of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to the completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6. Don't forget to work on memorizing that verse at home, and you'll have a chance to earn some cool prizes at our drive-thru party this Friday.
Hey guys, I've got my toolbox here today. What do you think I have in here today? Let's see. It's a flashlight. Now, why do you think a construction worker would need a flashlight? Let's watch this video and see what this tool has to do with today's story in Acts chapter 9.
Stories of the Bible. Paul. This is Saul. Saul was a Pharisee who hated the followers of Jesus so much that he would hunt them down to be brought to trial in Jerusalem. And he would even seek to murder them. Saul was uttering threats with every breath, and he was eager to kill the Lord's followers. So he went to the high priest. He asked him to write a letter to the Jews in Damascus that would allow him to arrest any Christians he found there. He wanted to bring them, both men and women, back to Jerusalem in chains. Now Saul went on his way. And as he came near Damascus, a light from heaven flashed around him, and he heard a voice that said, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" Saul cried out, "Who are you, Lord?" And the voice said, "I am Jesus. Rise and go into the city, and you will be told what to do." So Saul got up and he opened his eyes, but he couldn't see anything. So the men who were with Saul led him into the city. After 3 days, a man named Ananias came to Saul. He put his hands on Saul, and immediately Saul could see again. And with that, Saul became a follower of Jesus. He became the very thing he had tried to hunt. And he immediately began telling people that Jesus is the Son of God, and he taught them about the mercy of God that he had received. And all who heard him were amazed. He then went by a new name, Paul, as he began preaching not just to the Jewish people, but to everyone. Despite many difficulties like being imprisoned, shipwrecked, and narrowly escaping death multiple times, Paul continued to preach about Jesus. Paul said that he would do everything he could to save people and help them know God. And that's just what he did in order to reach people who would otherwise be unreached. And many came to know Jesus because of what Paul said. Paul taught many in his day through his letters. But even more have come to learn more about Jesus through the letters of Paul that can be read even to this day.
Okay, so did you figure out what this flashlight had to do with today's Bible story? Jesus shined a bright light from heaven on Saul to get his attention, and that encounter with Jesus on the road to Damascus became a turning point in Saul's life. Saul realized that Jesus had a better plan for his life, and that he needed forgiveness for the wrong things he had done. Saul turned from his old life of sin and believed in Jesus. And when he did, his life totally changed. In fact, it changed so much that he even was given a new name, Paul. Before he met Jesus, Saul spent his life trying to keep people from believing in Jesus. But once he experienced Jesus' forgiveness, Paul became a missionary who spent the rest of his life telling others the good news about Jesus. In Acts chapter 9, verse 20 through 22, the Bible says, "Immediately he began proclaiming Jesus in the synagogues, saying, 'He is the Son of God.' All who heard him were astounded and said, 'Isn't this the man in Jerusalem who was causing havoc for those who called on his name and came here for the purpose of taking them as prisoners to the chief priest?' But Saul grew stronger and kept confounding the Jews who lived in Damascus by proving that Jesus is the Messiah." See, even though Paul had done some pretty terrible things in his life, Jesus chose to love him and forgave him and used him for God's purpose. I want you to think about a sin you've committed, something wrong that you have done. Do you believe that Jesus loves you even when you've messed up? Jesus does love you regardless of your sin. And that's our big idea for today. Say it with me. Jesus loves me regardless of my sin. No matter what you've done, Jesus still loves you, and He will forgive you when you ask Him. Jesus loves you and has a great plan for your life. And part of that plan is that He wants you to put your faith in Him and trust His promises. And when you do, He will begin a good work in you that He will carry on to completion. God wants to do a great work through your life, just like He did through Paul. Let's pray. Father, we thank You so much for this story in the Bible that shows us how much Jesus loves us and how far that He's willing to go to forgive us of our sin. And Father, help us today as we think about the sins that we've committed, the wrongs that we have done. Help us to turn those things to You and trust Jesus to forgive us so that we can build on the foundation of His love and His forgiveness. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Wow, today we learned that Jesus loves us regardless of our sin. And even when we've messed up big time like Saul, Jesus is willing to forgive our sins. Let's celebrate that by singing a song, Forgiveness. So stand up and move and sing with us.
There's no way that we can hurt.
Missions excavator again, and this time it asked for a new security code.
Okay. Well, what was the question this time?
It says, why do we need missionaries?
You know, I'm not sure, but I bet that we can give our missionary friend Deanna a call again and see if she can help us out.
Let's do it.
Hey, Deanna.
Hey, Todd.
Hey, that answer you gave us yesterday worked great. But today we've got a new question for you.
Okay, great. I hope I can help again.
Okay, today it wants to know, why do we need missionaries?
Oh, wow. That's a tough question to answer. But I think as I look at the Bible and think about what God says in His Word, I see that from the beginning of time, God has had a plan that every tribe, every tongue, every nation will worship him. And that is his plan, is that all creation would worship him. And the reality right now, unfortunately, is that there are many in our world, even in our town of Portageville and in our state of Missouri and in our country and all across the globe, people don't yet know Jesus. Some of them don't have access to learn about him like we do. And others have access and they still don't know him yet. But we do missions because we want other people to be able to worship King Jesus as God has intended. I think about the verse Revelation 7:9 that says that it says, after this I looked and behold a great multitude that no one could number from every tribe, nation, tongue, people, and language stand before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes with palm branches in their hands, worshiping God. And I think about that. We do missions because we want other people to know God and be saved and get to enjoy him forever. So I hope that helps.
Yeah, that's, I've never thought about it like that. I think that's going to get us on the right track. Thank you so much.
Hey, good luck.
All right, bye.
Okay, Hunter, well, why don't you go give that answer a try? And kids, don't forget that you can help lay the foundation for Deanna's ministry in Zambia by giving toward our missions offering at VBS this year. You can bring your offering to our drive-through celebration this Friday night from 5 to 7 p.m. We'll see you then.
Ah!
Ouch! The sound of Hunter falling off a ladder means it's time for the daily challenge. Today our challenge is to memorize our theme verse, Philippians 1:6. It says, I am sure of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to the completion until the day of Jesus Christ. We want to challenge you guys at home to work on saying that verse perfectly from memory, because the Bible says it's important that we hide God's words in our hearts. Once you got it, have your parents record it, say it on video, and text us to us at 573-391-0727 or email thiggs@livingstonebaptist.org. We will do our best to feature the videos this week.
Okay, boys and girls, thanks for joining us for another day on the job site at Concrete and Cranes. Don't forget to keep building a strong foundation by doing the craft, game, and snack from your toolkit at home. We'll see you tomorrow.